calif, ragil istic, expialid, ocious.
That's not a word.
Of course it's a word. And unless I'm very much mistaken, I think it's going to prove a rather useful one. When trying to express oneself, it's frankly quite absurd to leaf through lengthy lexicons to find the perfect word. A little spontaneity keeps conversation keen. You need to find a way to say precisely what you mean. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
It doesn't mean anything.
It can mean exactly what you want it to. When Stone Age men were chatting, simply granting would suffice.
Now if they'd heard this word, they might have used it once or twice.
That's right.
I'm sure Egyptian pharaohs would have grasped it in a jiff. Mm-hmm. Then every single pyramid would bear this hieroglyph. Oh, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Saiyans and wild animals would not seem so ferocious.
Add some further flourishes, it's pseudo-coco-cocious.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
The Druids could have carved it on their mighty monoliths.
Oh yeah?
The ancient Greeks, I'm certain, would have used it in their myths.
I'm sure the Roman Empire only entered the abyss because those Latin scholars never had a word like this. If you say it softly, the effect can be hypnotious.
Check your breath before you speak in case it's halitosis.
Oh, bird.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Backwards, which is still wicked alive, sipsicatsilagarfila creepus.
She may be tricky, but she's bloody good.
So when the cat has got your tongue, there's no need for dismay. Just summon up this word and then you've got a lot to say.
Pick out those 18 consonants and 16 vowels as well, and put them in an order which is very hard to spell.